money, but you wouldn't do for free. Work is for slaves. And, anyway, in this case, I decided to produce it. I didn't finance the movie, it was Wild Bunch and co-producer to finance the movie, but the point, as for my purpose, is not making money. I don't want to buy a swimming pool. I just want to make movies that I feel are attractive. And I think in their case, they were not really, they were not trying to succeed. It's just what can you make in life that is valuable, and to make a movie that is truthful, that it talks about life as it is, makes sense. I'm sure, in my case, I didn't take many risks. I've already done movies that were hated by half of the film critics, but by the other half. At the end, Irreversible was successful. The next one was a commercial failure, but everybody talks about. But it's not the point. You come to life, you experience, and you go, and you enjoy the moment. But if you can leave something that is valuable, it's better. And that's what made me attract the call and say, oh, I want to be part of it. And I know that in his case, we all have family issues. I have family issues, he has family issues, Ami has family issues. But upon you say, well, let's do something worse with our lives. In his case, maybe because we live in a main London world, all my friends in France wanted to show the dick on screen. And I had to stop and say, no, come on, you're not going to be on screen, whatever. Everybody said, I'll be ready, I'll do whatever you want, shut it. No, I don't. Just shut your zip. I don't want to see it. I don't want you to move. And I was like, especially when they're drunk, they become very annoying. But I met Ron, and I said, this is a guy that is cool. He's not a sex maniac. He was serious. He's not. He's a very sentimental person. And I met Ami.
He's quite also
a very sentimental person. She's the most sentimental person in the world. But, and she's not a sex maniac. And she really didn't want to be in a movie. But also, when people say, I don't want to be an actress, or I don't want to be an actor. It's even more exciting. You say, these people are right. They don't want to be showing their face to everybody, like everybody else. You say, these people are normal. They just want to make life valuable, whatever. But I've been talking too much.
No, no, not at all.
I said it because, of course, of the nature of the film that doesn't depict anything that most people haven't lived here, besides maybe the last scenes in which the couple try things to save their couple that are risky and they don't succeed. But that may be the point where some people can disconnect, but I'm sure that all the rest of the movie, most people in this theater have experienced it. And for a woman, or Clara, or anybody else. You cannot stop thinking of how people are going to react. It's not about the movie itself. It's about how the reaction is going to be afterwards. Because people aren't always good. People are just envious, jealous. Everybody wants to be on top. And
it's not only about people being jealous or being on top, but imagine like one day I fall in love with a teacher. Like, and he's, how you say people you teach to, his students found out that his wife done a movie like this, like he got along with all his, credibility or whatever, or like all many little stuff who doesn't really matter. In what it's real, and that also if you find a man who really loves you, he will never
Can you hear him? You can say anything you want. You hear on Carl Podcast, you can say anything of it, clearly.
We're home, it's just the four of us.
For example, I love to work with children, and I was asking to myself, like, oh, will this movie in fact could kind of, yeah, other job, because it's something that open you some doors and close some other. But I still believe that if you really want to do one stuff, you can, and you will find a way.
I'd like to ask you, because